Hello and welcome or welcome back to my channel. How are we doing today, mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally? I am so excited for today's video. Today I will be giving you guys some recs for why choose romances. Now, before I begin, I just want to give a quick little disclaimer. With dark romance, sometimes the books get really dark. They get really dark. Sometimes some horror elements are introduced into it. Sometimes it's really spicy and there's minimal plot. Before I get into the video, I just want to let you guys know that especially for these recs, to check your trigger warnings. A lot of these books are super spicy, which comes with a lot of kinks that might scare some people. So if you want to give these books a try, make sure to check those warnings beforehand. For my first book, it is Satan's Affair by H.D. Carlton. Satan's Affair is a why choose dark romance novella, and it follows Sybil, aka Sibby. And if her name sounds familiar, she is from the Cat and Mouse duet. I don't think you necessarily have to read this book before you read the duet. I do recommend it because Zayd is mentioned in this book and Sibby is also mentioned later on in the books. So I read it in between Haunting and Hunting. Some things are spoiled in the Cat and Mouse duet before you read Satan's Affair. Sibby works at a traveling fair called Satan's Affair, and there are haunted houses, amusement rides, so on so forth. Sibby works in a haunted attraction with her henchmen, where she basically sniffs out bad guys. I can't really explain the plot too much since it is a novella. It is pretty short. I think it's about 180 pages. This book gets really dark, and I mean that in regards to how she takes down her prey. She gets very stabby, okay? I'll say that now. She gets very stabby. And it is gory. Cults are mentioned in this book. Once I read the Cat and Mouse duet, I absolutely fell in love with Sibby. So you kind of get her background story in Satan's Affair. If you're looking for something quick and spicy, then this is your book. I think that Sibby is hilarious. The plot twist at the end, I think the plot twist for me really makes this book. And I really like the little superpower that she has. For my next book, it is Den of Vipers by K.A. Knight. And okay, I know you guys, I know. This is one of those books where you hate it or you love it or you're okay with it, right? This was my first why choose book and it was so new to me and I ate it up. I ate it up. It is a captive romance. Why choose? There are some mafia elements that are brought into the story. It is not the main plot line. I feel like we never really know the mafia dealings between the guys. It's just kind of thrown in there. So that's not really the main forefront of the book. Roxy's dad owes money to the Vipers. And what does her father do? He ends up making a deal with them in exchange for her. So he basically sells her to them to pay off his debt. Now there are four Vipers. And okay, with this story, right, let me just let you know that most of the story takes place in their apartment. Okay, if you're looking for something super spicy, then this is your book. Okay, this is a thick book, you guys. You're getting spice on almost every single chapter. I think that it really picks up a little bit towards the end of the book. I personally liked this book because of each of the characters. Each of the characters are so different from each other. At times I was a little bit with Roxy, but I can't deny that she is just so feisty. She is so feisty, especially being trapped with these four men. She kind of held her ground a little bit. She had a great time, and I had a great time reading this book. So again, if you don't mind the 600 pages and you're just looking for something really spicy and you're just there for the characters, I say give this book a try. There is one scene. It includes a knife, you guys. It includes a knife. I'm just warning you on that part. And so for my next book, this is, I would say it's a contemporary Why Choose book. That is Flock by Kate Stewart. In this book, we follow Cecilia. Cecilia doesn't really have a good relationship with her father, and they make a deal where she goes to live with him. I believe it's for a year, and during that year, she goes to work at his company. She meets Sean, and automatically from the get, there's attraction there. He invites her back to a party, and that's kind of how the story starts. Then we meet another love interest. This book is part of a series. It is the Ravenhood series, and it's sort of like a Robin Hood retelling. And with Flock, all right, you're going to get confused. Point blank, you're going to get confused. There's a lot of secrets going on. Everything is kept hush, and you won't find out things till later on in the series. For me, I really like the second and the last book in the series. Flock, you kind of just really get to know the characters, and it kind of sets you up for the dynamic between everybody. Guys, the floaty scene, that's all I'm going to say, the floaty scene. I do suggest you should read the other books because everything starts making sense to you. The music in the book was top tier, and I couldn't help but fall in love with the love interest too. For my next book, that is Touched by Sin by Harley Beck. This is part of the Sins of the Fallen series. It is ongoing. So there's so far 3 books, and each book is left on a cliffhanger. So I'm not sure when the next 4th installment is coming out, but I'm just letting you know that if you do decide to give this a try. How the story begins is that Aurelia is an angel who lives in Eden. She's taught specific things in Eden. It's kind of kept her mind closed, if that makes sense. And she starts wondering things, and she starts hearing whispering near the gates, right? She gets intrigued, and one day the gates open up for her. She decides to leave, and she starts wandering the woods, and who finds her? 3 fallen angels. And the books I've mentioned so far are spicy, but guys, let me tell you, this spice in this book had me shook. I have never read something like this before. It is a dark paranormal Why Choose romance. There are multiple love interests, so I believe it's FFMMM. I believe there's 5. I would say it's kind of captor captive, just like Den of Vipers. They end up capturing with her and they corrupt her. I really enjoyed the series. With Harley Beck, you're always going to get plot twists. The plot twist in this book had me immediately downloading the second book. And again, with the set, like, guys, this series, I recommend this series. If you're into like dark paranormal, especially Why Chooses, the whole fallen angels and demons, I say give this book a try. Again, make sure you read the trigger warnings for this one specifically. All right, guys, and for my next book, it is Heartless Heathens by Santana Knox. This is one of my recent reads, and I enjoyed this book. Oh my goodness. In the beginning of the book, Santana mentions that this is not a Notre Dame retelling. It's sort of a nod to it. For example, you get the name Frollo. The way that this story begins is that Romina is kept in a bell tower all her life. She was raised there. She's grown up there. She's kept there by, I believe he's the archbishop. I think he's the archbishop, and his name is Frollo. And he keeps her locked up there until 3 heathens come along and decide that the bell tower is theirs and anything in there. And where is our girl Romina? Yes, she is there, and she becomes theirs. This book is kind of in a dystopian world. There was a sickness that happens, and the church takes over as the government. There's a lot of religion talk in here. There is Satanism, but not in the way that you think. There is a disclaimer in the beginning of the book as well that explains it, but it does make a big impression in the book because, again, it's the heathens going against the church. And I had fun with this book. This is definitely one of my favorite Why Chooses of the year. Being as Romina is very inexperienced, that kind of sets you up for her character majority of the book. I loved Sunny, Corvin, and Felix. Oh my goodness, I love them so much. And I started liking their dynamic towards the end. Plot I would say it's like medium paced. Very fun book and spicy, and overall had a great time. And again, one of my favorite YA chooses of the year. And now for my last recommendation, this is Into the Night by DK. And this is my recent read. I finished this up maybe a day or two ago. We follow Winver and she moves to this town looking to kind of start new. So she loves Halloween and ends up going to a haunted house. When she goes to this haunted house, she is met with three masked men. Yes, there's masked men in this. They start stalking her. They start taunting her. I loved the little ghost aspect in this book. I also really like the FMC in this book. She has been through a lot and she decides that she's never gonna let someone step all over her ever again. She is very feisty and she does fight back with them. I really thought the plot was fun, especially the ending. The ending, we are left in a cliffhanger, and let me tell you, oh my goodness, that was a good cliffhanger. I'm so excited to see what's gonna happen in the next book. I believe this is a debut novel. I thought it was well done. You get so much with this book, spice and plot. So I say definitely give this a try if you want a little haunted, Halloween, kind of spooky. All right, guys. And these are my recommendation for YA Choose romances. I love reading YA Chooses. I love falling in love with the multiple love interests. I love to see a feisty FMC who fights back. And if you're just looking for some spice with minimal plot or maybe medium plot, then definitely give these books a try. Next week, I think I'm going to post my wrap-up for last month and possibly maybe another video. We'll see though, we'll see, because I always say that and then, you know, life happens. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more. Follow my Bookstagram to see the books that I'm currently reading. If you are looking for bookish accessories and bookish apparel, definitely take a look at my links below. We are reading, we are having fun. And for my femme fatales and morally gray pitch black villainy readers, I hope you have a great day today and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.
We bring the rain to the motherfucking earth. That's all. We need to the hell is polluted.